I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of being complete. I said the
war. War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Let's see, are you a boy or a... It's a boy. A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. Our beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about... That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up. You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh, oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be? Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions. Get the baby out of here. Move, move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on. Okay?
We need a doctor, not a dead man. Fail to meet my expectations and there will be no
repercussions. James and his cheery charity.
Decorations.
May your future be bright.
Don't look straight into the light, pal. Like you'll hurt your eyes. It's just something you get used to down here. Come on over here, son. Come on. Walk to Daddy. You can make it. There you go. My goodness, just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit. You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pen you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible, Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play. Experiment to prepare. Prepare to survive. Of course I miss her. I miss her so much.
Surprise!
Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it? He is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your
Congratulations, young man.
I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official Vault responsibilities. So here you are. As Overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool. You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess. Ha! I knew I surprised you. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak, issue 14, and with no missing pages. I found this in a box of my father's old things, believe it or not. Imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody was 10 once. Well, I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay? Happy birthday.
Oh,
having
man,
a good time?
A
it wasn't
boy.
Easy keeping
I
this
wish
a
I
secret.
Was 10.
Now go on. I'm sure everyone else would like a chance to talk to the birthday boy.
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
What, are you two best friends now? Hey, Wally, I think Paul's.
Happy birthday, Sonny.
Yeah, Paul.
I hope you appreciate the effort Amata put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason. Don't presume too much on her friendship, young man. I'm still the Overseer, and I'm still in charge of this vault and everyone in it.
Why don't you introduce us to your new best friend?
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My, my, my. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Such a nice, polite young man you are. Don't ever lose your gift to speaking your mind so directly. We could use more of that down here. Here you go. A nice, sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. You're the birthday boy. No sharing required today.
Who do you mean,
go ahead, you can eat the sweet roll now. It's your birthday.
This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
Hey! Nice party, butthead. Now get lost before I have to make you cry.
I am...
Hey!
Goodbye about the cake. Simply mortified.
K-I-S-S. Yeah.
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything? As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A series is a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability. Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday. Not much, but I hope you like it.
I told you not to act all official. I know. Joking, but I'm not sure anyone.
Allow me
did.
To wish you a happy
Nonsense.
Birthday.
People always
I
enjoy my
piece.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer. You what? Dang, I love those sweet rolls old Lady Palmer makes.
You
stay out of my way, you got it?
Yeah,
can I tell you to stop?
What'd Butch want? I thought you were in trouble there for a second. God, he really is a butthead. Oh well, you can always count on Butch to make an ass of himself. Get it?
Your girlfriend.
Shut up, dork.
Yeah,
no,
we don't need
to
stop. Right, Butch?
You mean yeah, because we've already got one?
Thanks for coming, Stanley. I know you were busy with the water purifier.
Jonas?
Everything's fine, I hope.
Hey, Doc. We're all set down here. Don't worry about. Me
and Andy got her all Thanks. Mixed up again. I'll send him right down.
I wasn't worried. You can fix anything, right? Anyway.
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
Can I tell you to stop bothering us?
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party. They sure did. My, my. 10 years old already? Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers. And now look at you, a great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy. Since this was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote you a poem just for you. I hope you like it. Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
How are you enjoying the party? Creations, you know?
Yeah, I got one.
Oh, the really? Mackers. They're
Super
lovely.
Cool, right?
You did such
hey,
a splendid
Smalley,
job.
The game. You or me? No way.
Happy birthday.
So, what do you think we should call our game? It's gotta be totally killer, though.
Thank you for coming,
hey,
Miss Beatrice. I hope you're having a nice time.
Who wants to go around all day?
Oh, my goodness.
Enjoy the party, sir?
Bah! I only showed up because Amata's friends with the brat. Give them a few more minutes, and then I want that place cleaned up and everybody back to work.
Proper cleaning and maintenance.
Sure thing, sir.
Devices operation for this and future generations.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level. You sure are. Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that. If you can wait just one more minute, I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
Are you ready for your surprise? The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work, so I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old. But it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try? We sure can't, unless we want the Overseer beating down our door. Jonas and I have found a place, though. Come on.
Happy birthday, buddy. I hope you have fun with it. Hey, you don't turn 10 every day. Now go on and let me see you shoot something.
BB gun? Just. Good work. That's one less Rat Roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with a big game hunter.
Smile!
Boys and girls have different parts.
What is her problem right anyway? So, I'm the overseer's daughter, Gloria. So what? That like, I get any kind of special treatment.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your goat exam. Go on now. You've got a goat to take. The Generalized Occupational Aptitude Test. Goat. Everyone here in the vault takes it when they're 16. Helps to figure out what sort of a job you'll have here in Vault 101 when you get a bit older. So, pay attention and try not to fall asleep. You know what the overseer says? We're born in the vault, we die in the vault. Each is tested to determine their abilities, that they may work for the betterment of all vault residents. Huh. Sound familiar? That's not the way it works. And it won't do to go around asking questions like that. Especially not around the overseer. I want to tell you something now. It's important, so listen closely. This place, this vault, it's not perfect, I know. But it is your home. You're safe here. Stay on the overseer's good side, and you always will be. You understand? You need to appreciate all you have. Because what's up there, on the outside, that's not the life I want for you. And it's not what your mother wanted for you either. Hey, it's not my call. Those are the rules. You're 16 now, so this year you take the goat. Come on, it's not so bad. Everyone has to take it. You'll do just fine. That's what the overseer says, isn't it? He's not about to let anyone else in, so I guess that's how it'll have to be. You're here now, and it's a hell of a lot better than being up there. All your mother and I ever wanted was for you to be safe, and you're safe here. Your mother, she was beautiful, but beyond the beauty you've seen. There's just so much those old photos can never show. And she was passionate. About life, about love. But most of all she was passionate about you. When she became pregnant, it was the happiest I had ever seen her. Ah, she had great things in mind for you. And so, time for you to stop stalling and get to class. Please, son, please, take these achievement tests seriously. The last thing I need is your mother's ghost haunting me because her only child became a garbage burner. Take care, son. Now get out of here, and good luck.